Brendan Borden. I'm currently a supplemental instructional leader for Chemistry 130 here at the University of Tennessee. Today we'll be going over how to combine equilibrium constant values. Okay, here in this problem we've been given two different equations with equilibrium constant values. What they want us to solve is they want us to find the equilibrium constant value for this equation. In order to do that, all we have to do is add the top equation to the bottom equation in order to get this. But before we can add both of these equations, we have to modify them in order to get the values that we have down here. So for the first equation, hydrogen fluoride dissociates into hydrogen ions and fluoride ions. In the final equation, we know that we have two hydrogen fluorides and two fluoride ions. Therefore, we have to double the equation on the top. We put 2 in front of each thing in the top equation. Now, if we double everything in the top equation, then we have to square the equilibrium constant value. Okay, so now that we've done that, we need to look at this equation and see how we can add it to get this. So in order to add both of these equations together, we must reverse this equation in order to get C2O4 minus on the left side. Okay, so once we've reversed the second equation, we now have to divide the equilibrium constant value by 1. So that gives us 1 over 3.8 times 10 to the minus 6. Once we've made modifications to the first and second equations, we can now add both of these equations in order to get our overall equation. When we add, we need to check to make sure there's no spectator ions in our first two equations. So we do see that we do have two spectator ions, and it's the 2H plus in the reactant side of the second equation and 2H plus in the product side of the first equation. So we'll cross those out. Once we've crossed those out, we can now add the first equation to the second equation in order to get our overall equation here. Because we've added these two equations together, we now take the equilibrium constant values from the first equation and the second equation, and we multiply those together. So this gives us 6.8 times 10 to the minus 4 squared times 1 over 3.8 times 10 to the minus 6. If we plug this in our calculator, we should get an equilibrium constant value of 0.12. This has been my explanation of how to combine equilibrium constant values.